Yes, we did it. We did it, you guys. We made it back home in one piece. In your face, Exegol. No more going to that horrible wasteland. Well, what did me and Fred not expect? For not only Ben and Drunas to blow up the entire Sith Citadel, but even get us the heck out of there faster than the place could blow up. Well, I don't know about you guys, but me and Morty had a lot more enemies for our lives and eventually survived way bigger explosions than that. So in that case, it's pretty much not the only time where the main villain survives the explosion and comes back in the future episode just to haunt us. As a matter of fact, you three, yes. But now I suggest we all just forget about it and move on with our day. There you are, Rick. Oh, Rennie. And Tosaka. So, your stupid misadventures on Exegol, you two. I don't want to brag or some of you idiots, but might suggest you get the heck out of here before me and Morty threaten to sexually assault you two. You wouldn't admit it? Actually, Rick would, and he's also more than happy to. By the way, where's Revenan? So, Archer, last time you saw him was in the backyard. Suckers. There it is. It's all mine now. Hey, man. Sup? What you doing? About to mess with Rick and Morty's drum set. Oh, okay, have fun with that. Or, by the way, Archer, don't tell Rick and Morty, oh, Tosaka bitch, I mess with his drum set. You know they say, snitches get them stitches. Yeah, that's right, my man, you and I be good. Now, if you excuse me, I got a date with Senor Drum Set. Fuck you, Rick and Morty. Fuck you.